Okay. Sorry about that. We lost again. Got dropped. That's all right. We're back and I got things running again. So what I'm working on is this roof color. And I got it pretty much made. I actually need a different brush. This is getting quite beat up. And so I need to find another square brush that's not as beat up. And here we go. Alrighty. So there's some details I'm gonna add there, but for the most part, that's it. Go. So I got to put some highlights in here now, and that's the highlight of the gutter. And that, that, I'm gonna jump down there, and then put some. Okay, so other than details and the brown around the windows and all that, I gotta put all that in. I gotta finish this. I need to finish this roof over here. So put that in. I was gonna paint through that gazebo. I think I'm just gonna leave it. So just not gonna be that big of a deal. And coming along nicely. Now I need to get some dark gray and put it in where that gazebo is going. Can't do any of the poles because it's just not a good idea. I gotta put in all the other stuff first. So I have some darker green house color to put in over here. In some texture here, there, and put a little bit on this one. A little bit more. So I have a ton of this shingle color, which is going to be really good to make my concrete. Okay, so I'm going to put another little coat on this little roof that I have left over here, and then I got plenty of it to make my concrete. I don't need a lot of white for the concrete, so I'm gonna let that area dry, and then I'm gonna start putting all the concrete. Excuse me again, sorry about that. Now I have a little bit of that rock color to make. More blue, a little bit darker. I have some rocks to put in here, I have a fence to put in there. All right. We need a little bit more of that color way back here. And then that gets covered. Doesn't get covered, but I mean. All right, so the concrete. Gonna make a lot. So it's gonna be a little bit here. So I apologize for losing signal a little bit ago. It seems to be an ongoing thing with me every time I live stream. So there's some tech stuff that I'm gonna have to figure out. But for the most part, hopefully it put it right on the same one. I don't know if it does that or adds another post. But for those who were patient enough to come back, thank you. I appreciate it. That concrete color turned out nice. Crops the corner down here, hugs it a little bit, kind of lose the end of it. And that water looks amazing, so I can't wait to mix that. That's going to really make it pop. The last swimming pool I did, exactly what happened. I mean, the painting I thought turned out really good. The house, the architecture. And when I put the pool in, kind of contrast really makes a difference. You know, and it makes other things that aren't as up front and in your face pop a little bit more. Together nicely, covering that those where I put those chairs, because I'm gonna paint those in here in a minute. So I want to get that sometimes I get little particles in there. Dried acrylics or dried little pieces of paint. It's kind of like I gotta scrape it off or it leaves lumps. Alright, so once I get this done, I think I'm gonna work on the pool color real quick. Once I get the pool color and get some of the furniture in, I'm actually gonna let that dry. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back to my these grays, and I'm going to put in the details on my on the windows. Oh yeah, that looks, I like it.
take it.
So, holding the brush is one of my things that I like to hone in on for newbies that are painting. So if you're just starting out to paint, remember that, first of all, it is not a pencil. The brush is not a pencil. And you can't hold it like a pencil and expect to get good results. As a matter of fact, three-point hold is actually how you should be holding a pencil. Now, some people like to use their thumb curl around, but when you're not using the fingertips of your fingers, you're losing control. That's where control is at. And you're actually forcing yourself to make it harder for your body to do something that is requires some focus and detail and control. So when you don't hold the brush the right way, then you get stuff like just aches and pains in your hand, or just in general, when you go to, like, if you hold your hand on the canvas all the time, you only have this much mobility. If you hold it up and use a free hand, you have this much mobility. So right there, that's the first sign that if you're constantly holding it way down here like this and trying to do a detail, that's not really where you want to be. You want to have that brush right above the cuff. That way you have complete control using your wrist, bottom of your palm on your wrist, as your control. I mean, sometimes when you're doing really, really small details, you have to use the side of your hand or the pinky. I like using the pinky, so I'm going like this. And that always works. But 3 points is what I recommend you use if you're learning how to paint. And I recommend you use it for writing. So if you're a writer and you hold the pencil funny, I recommend you try changing your grip. Okay? So there's a lot of details there that I gotta put in. And some of these details are gonna get put in the studio. As I've done before, I like getting just the main part done. Once I'm really happy with it, I put a few details in, but it's off to the studio after that. Because I just have a little bit, I like to take my time with those things. And sometimes it doesn't, if you don't take your time, it doesn't always work that great. And that's a fact. That's something that I like to teach to my students. If you take your time, you'll go faster. Because if you don't, you make lots of mistakes. And then what happens is, well, you have to go back and fix stuff. So there you have it. It's my psychology of it. And it seems to work. I mean, they are receptive to it. And it's been a good way for me to teach and get results with these kids. You know, with their holding the pencil. You know, teachers don't have time these days to do that, to teach all that stuff. You know, how to hold the pencil, blah, blah, blah. Let alone get kids to do the work. So that's something that I like to talk about in class, because I think it's important. And if we don't start talking more to our kids about little things like that, they're gonna struggle. They're gonna struggle in many different ways. All right, so I have all that painted. Now what I can do is do the gazebo legs, or pulse. So I'm gonna put one right here. I'm gonna put one right here. I'm gonna put one over here. One of those times where I use my hand or my fingers. I gotta put in, mix that color in there. So I'm gonna do this table over here. Top of that. open up that umbrella for them. There we go. A little bit of a highlight. The top. Winning good. So I got to make a little bit of room. This is for those chairs. They're wicker chairs, so they're definitely brown. So I'm just gonna put a medium brown, and then put some details in it later. Put them in there. So I'll put some shadows in there. There's two wicker chairs, one being darker than the other. Oh, they're about the same color. So I'm gonna go back to that color. There you go, there's that. And then I'm gonna put in this little piece of wood here. And then put some highlights in there. There's that. Then I'm gonna put a little texture, rock texture here. One of the things I like to do at the end of it, but I think I'll just to kind of finish this up a little bit. All right, now I'm gonna do the water. I'm gonna do some of the decorative on the inside of the pool, finish the water, and then put in this fence over here, and then I think it'll be done at this point. And we're still doing good on our live stream. Great. And thank you again for tuning in. I appreciate the views. Please share if you feel like it. If you don't want to, that is completely okay. But sharing is caring. And so if you like it, it helps us out. So we appreciate the likes, but we appreciate the shares, because then more people see them. So people can't see it if you don't share it. But I appreciate everyone watching today. And thank you to Kathy and her husband for having me come out here and paint their house. It's been fun so far. And I'm about to do this pool color. And get her done. That didn't take long. See what I tell you? Isn't that cool how that just... I just need to make some shadow color. Okay, now I gotta
gotta do some trimming. Little details here with some gray color. This light gray. Blue for this gray that I made, because it's definitely bluer. Now I'm gonna do some reflection. I gotta do some designs on the side of the saw a little bit. I'm not gonna get too crazy. Just gonna do some patterning. There you go. And a little bit of yellow. Some quick outlines, kind of illustrate some things. Concrete. And a little bit of a shadow there. And for some
so the pool is kind of finished, or is finished, and there's not really a whole lot of details to put in there. And only other thing I want to do over here is put in this bush with the green that I have left, and be able to kind of well, I want to get the bush in it because I want to do that fence. So, I'm going to make some dark green from this green that I have here. There we go. That. And there's this big green one here. That, and we'll put some rocks in there later, but for the most part that is all I'm gonna do right there, other than drop in a few little highlights here. I remember to put my yellow in it because I want to do here, like I said, I want to put in that fence. And I'm going to also try and put in some rocks, big rocks here. And
already. So that fence stops right there. Four. That. Of course, when I take it back, I'll also add little deep shadows that really clean it up, like stuff like that, and you know, pop it in here and there. I'll just, it's just more like just grazing things with a little bit of shadow, going over things that need to be dark, dropping in drop shadows like underneath things and other stuff that really make everything pop after a while. Like if I put in that shadow, I'm gonna put right here, I'm gonna put the shadow in right here, right underneath that. Look at what it does. I you know, those are things that we are so used to seeing all the time, you don't even think about it. But when you put it in, look at it. Wow, it really defines that. Makes it like live in a way. Put a little bit there. A little bit there. And then I'm just gonna drop in the ends of these nice and then we'll do the details of them later, but I'm gonna drop these in. Put that one in there. Okay, and then I'll do one more, but I'm just gonna draw it in because I ran out of paint. I'm gonna mix it. I can paint both of that right there. And then those will get detailed in. Boom. And then there's really not much else to do other than those little small details. But I really love how this turned out. All the colors turned out nice. There's just one more little thing that I want to put in here, so because I want to see these windows in there. Are these gable windows. They probably bring in some beautiful light at the top, but I wasn't going to do this without finishing these. And I kind of left them because I was, you know, focused on other areas. And so now that I have them in, I can go ahead and paint them. And look at that, it really does a lot just adding those little windows. And it's crazy what how much it changes things, just little details that you would think, hey, maybe we don't need those, but no, they're an important part of bringing things and making them look together. So I'm gonna do that, and then one more little shadow that I need to put in here. There we go. And I am really happy with the way this turned out now. Really happy. And I want to thank everybody for coming on and watching. Again, please share if you can. Like it if you can. If you can't, that's fine. I'm appreciating you viewing it. And so, until the next time, we'll see you then.
Thank you all for watching, and I'll probably be doing one in another couple of days, and we'll see you then. Have a good week.